Newsweek fails to dig up dirt, resorts to sloppy plagiarism hit piece on Ivanka. Have you ever repeated something you previously said? Apparently you should be accused of plagiarism, at least if Newsweek is in charge. The leftist magazine just claimed that Ivanka Trump plagiarized one of her own speeches while in India. All because she repeated several parts of a previous speech that she herself wrote. Yes, the mainstream media is now so desperate to attack anyone named Trump that they will invent accusations that don't even make sense. Several lines the 36-year-old delivered Tuesday had been directly pulled from her poorly attended November 2 speech in Tokyo, where she attended the World Assembly for Women alongside Japanese President Shinzo Abe, Newsweek writer Chris Ryder declared. The problem? First, you can't plagiarize yourself, that's the literal opposite of the definition of plagiarism. Second, public figures who give many speeches often reuse the same material. Think about it, when a presidential candidate, whether it's Donald Trump or Barack Obama, does 5 appearances a day on the campaign trail, do you think they write an entirely new speech every time? They use the same message in multiple places, a practice which every journalist in the country is aware of and can quickly be confirmed by checking transcripts or videos. Or how about a motivational speaker, like Tony Robbins? He no doubt gives the same talk at different venues. Is a stand-up comedian repeating the same practiced routine plagiarizing as well, Newsweek? Bizarrely, the magazine article's writer even acknowledged that public figures often reuse parts of past speeches, but then somehow tried to twist this well-known fact into an attack on Ivanka Trump anyway. Ivanka, Trump's recycling of her old speech could be more significant than simply her not having anything else to say about women's empowerment, Wine reporter Chris Ryder. Yes, Chris, one of the most powerful and successful women in the world has nothing to say about women's empowerment because she gives a lot of speeches. Cutting-edge reporting. We'll watch for the Pulitzer. It must be pointed out that charges of plagiarism are serious. Students have lost their degrees and journalists have lost their jobs when actual plagiarism is proven, which makes throwing this accusation around for a slick headline an extremely questionable decision. Newsweek tried to backpedal after they were roundly criticized for the article. The headline of this story was changed to reflect that Trump reused portions of an earlier speech rather than plagiarized it, a correction sheepishly admitted, hidden at the very bottom of the article. As of 3 p.m. Eastern on Thursday, however, the Twitter post from Newsweek's official account still claimed that Ivanka Trump was a plagiarist. Examples like these are why the American people no longer trust the mainstream media. The bias and seething hatred against the president and his family are not even hidden anymore. Americans are tired of being lied to by desperate magazines and news outlets that used to stand for the truth.